This we are going to see the merge algorithm. Already we have seen merge sort will split the array based on the mid value, and this is what we have got. That is, if you represent them as a tree, recursive tree, then you get the value like this. You could split that array. Initially the array is 1 to 10. These are the values. This is spread based on the mid value. It is print split at 1 to 5 and 6 to 10. Again, this is based on the mid value. It splits so on. This already we have seen in the previous video. Now, by applying the merge algorithm, how they will be sorted? That is what we are going to see now. So let us take this two, this value. That is this and this sublist we are going to sort. So first, for this merge, we are going to pass the value. Yes, low is here. Low value is nothing but 1, and then this is the mid value, 1, 1. You remember the merge sort called first it with low and mid, and then in the next merge sort mid plus 1 and high. So this is mid plus 1 and high. So here this is low and mid. This is mid plus 1 and high. So now it is 1, mid is 1, and then high is 2. Okay, so 1, 1, and then high is 2. Now with this value, this will be called, this merge will be called with this value. Now how this 1 and 2 1 value, these two values are going to sorted, and it becomes like 285 and 310. This is what we are going to see now. Here initially we declare a temporary variable called b, okay, with which can hold the 10 element. That is the sorted value. So here h equal to, we initialize h equal to 1, and then I equal to also 1, low value, and then j equal to mid plus 1. Mid is 1, so 1 plus 1, it is 2. So j value is now 2. Now here we are going to check this while loop. While h is less than mid, h value is less than or equal to mid. Yes, it is equal to mid. This is low, and this is the h value, and this is the mid value. So it is less than or equal. Yes, it is, this value is true. Now here we check, well, j is this value, less than or equal to high. This is high. Yes, this is also equal to high. So now it go inside. If a of h, what is a of h? It is a of 1. A of 1 is this. That is what a of 1. So the first value. If a of 1 is less than a of j, a of j is nothing but 2. So is it less than 310? Is not less than 285. So this will be skipped, and else portion will get executed. Where we have b of i value is, we have 1. So in b of 1, we place a of j. A of j is 285. So 285 value is placed, and then what we do, j is incremented to 3. J plus 1. Already j is 2. So now I is also after this here. After this else statement, I becomes I equal to 2. Already I is 1. So I plus 1, it is 2. Now while loop goes again. Now still h is less than mid, but here j becomes 3, which is not less than or equal to high. It becomes more than high. So this while loop is not executed. Now it comes here. Is h is greater than mid? No, h is equal to mid. So this if class also will be skipped, and then else statement is executed. Where here we have this else we have a for loop where k equal to 1 to mid, which is nothing but here k, h is also 1 and mid is also 1. So one time this loop will be executed where b of 2, I value is, latest value of I is 2. So in b of 2 we put a of ak, which is nothing but a of 1. A of 1 is nothing but our 310. So 310 is placed, and then it's over because 1 to 1, 1, 1 time only it will execute. Now it comes to the next for loop where k ranges from what? K ranges from low is 1, 1 to 2. So here what we do, in a of 1, okay, we write b of 1 where b of 1 is 285, and then again it go inside where we write a of 2 is equal to 310. So if you see that AF1 and AF2, they are all sorted. Previously, AF1 is this and AF2 is this. After regulation, it becomes 285 becomes here and 310. So within these two, this is sorted. Now we will get execute the next. That is, this is over and this becomes sorted like this after executing this merge. Now we'll say 1, 2, 3. It is nothing but between these two sublets. These two sublets we have done. Now we do this. So this is the low, this is the mid, and this is the high. Now let me take that value 2 and this, and 3 is the high. Now what happens? 1, 2 and 3 high. Now what is the value of H? H is the low value. I is also low value. J is mid plus 1. Here mid is 2. So 2 plus 1 it is 3 now. Then here we go inside the while loop. While H is less than the mid value. Yes, H is less than or equal to. So H is this and this is middle. It is less than. Less than the middle value. So now it is true. Then J is nothing but here we have 3. Isn't it? 2 plus 1. It is 3. So J is less than high. It is equal to high. So in that case, the both case are true. So now we go inside. Now you check whether A of H. What is A of H? A of 1. A of 1 is now we have sorted that. So we have to take the sorting value, sorted value only. 285 and 310. A of 1, A of 2. So is it A of 1? A of H is 1. A of 1 is less than or equal to A of 3. Which is nothing but what is A of 3? It is 179. If it is less than, then this value. But here we have 285. Okay, A of 1 is 285 and A of J is 179. Again, this is greater. So this statement will not be executed and this will come. So here what we do? B of I. B of I is 1. In that, what you would write is A of 3 because it is A of J. A of 3 is 179. So now we write 179 here and we make the J to increment. So now it becomes 4 and then I becomes 2. Now it comes. So now while loop here, even if this is correct, this is true, but here what happened? J is 4, it is not less than high. So this while loop is skipped and this it comes out. Now here we check, is it H is greater than mid? No, 1 is less than, so this also will be skipped and then it comes here, this statement. So for K, now what we do? For H is 1, 1 to mid, mid is nothing but here we have 2. So 1 to mid, what we do? B of, in B of 2, already B of 1 we have written some value. In B of 2, A of 1. So what is A of 1? We have to take the sorted previous element. Already it is sorted and overwritten. So it is nothing but in A of 1, we have 285. So 285 is returned and then I becomes incremented. Now it becomes B of 3. When it go inside, I becomes 2 plus 1, 3. And again it will go loop because it will be executing up to 2. So in B of already B of 2 is there, now B of 3. In B of 3, what you write is A of 2. A of 2 is 310. So it is equal to 310. This is over. Now up to 2. 1 to 2 it executes. Now K equal to low to high. What is low? It is 1. High is 3. So 1 to 3, what it will do? Whatever is in A of 1, A of 2, A of 1, it will return the B of 1 value. According to B of 1 to B of 1. B of 1 is already we have 179. And in A of 2 we have 285. So that will be returned. And then B A of 3 we have 310. And so on. So now these three are sorted. So you can see that. Again, it will take this value. That is, this as a middle. This as a high. This as a middle. And this as a high value. And again, the loop condition. So you can execute like that. It works. The algorithm works in this way. And finally, the sorting takes place between these two big sublists, and then these together form a bigger list, merge to form a bigger original array. Where then and there, the sorted list will be overwritten, and then we will finally have a correct order of the sorted order of the list.